mitosis in my toes, meiosis in my ovaries. That was my favorite mnemonic device from AP Biology class. It's referring, of course, to the two general flavors of cell division, mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis, which is what this video is about, happens all over our bodies, like in our toes, whenever our cells need to make more cells. Meiosis only happens in our gonads, our ovaries and testes, to make gametes, eggs and sperm. When a cell undergoes mitosis, the resulting cells wind up with the same amount of DNA as the original cell. In meiosis, on the other hand, the resulting cells wind up with half the amount of DNA as the original cell before the division. That's obviously the simplest explanation ever. In class, you'll spend a lot of time learning all of the details and what's happening at the molecular level, but we're not going to cover that in this video. Today, we're going to learn a lab technique that will allow us to visualize mitosis happening in onion root cells. Yeah, with our eyes. We can just look at mitosis like it's no big deal. But you will get the most out of this video if you're already familiar with the phases of mitosis. So if you'd like to brush up on those, you can head on over to the links in the description, which will send you to a bunch of resources that can help you out. Okay, let's start the experiment. You'll need a vial of farmer's fixative, AKA one part glacial acetic acid, three parts ethanol, scissors, forceps, and scalpels, a vial of one normal hydrochloric acid, a dish of distilled water, a dish of 2% acetocarmine stain, microscope slides and cover slips, a light microscope, and actively growing plant roots. I'm using scallions. I've let their roots grow in water for a few days prior to the experiment. First, I'll cut off some root tips into the vial of farmer's fixative and leave them for at least 4 hours. Overnight is great too. The chemicals will preserve the DNA in the roots. Then I'll transfer them to the vial of hydrochloric acid and let them sit for 2 minutes to soften the root tissue. Next, I'll move them to the dish of water for a quick rinse. Then another move to the dish of acetocarmine where they'll sit for 5 to 10 minutes. This will stain the cell's chromatin red and allow us to see the DNA, but you can use any DNA or chromatin-specific stain for this step. And then it's just one more move to their final resting place, a clean microscope slide with a drop of distilled water on it. I'm going to chop off most of the root and discard it, leaving behind just 1 millimeter of the very tip of the root, because this is where all of the cell division is happening and will give us our best chance of seeing mitosis. Once that's done, I'll pop on a cover slip and use the blunt end of my forceps to squash the cells. Don't be shy, they should be very squished. And finally, the moment of truth. Let's put the slide on the microscope and see what we can see. Okay, here are a bunch of squash cells, great. Let's look around. Ah, that's definitely some mitosis going on. Oh my gosh, anaphase. As plain as day, look at those chromosomes separating. Way to go, chromosomes. Okay, I'm actually not gonna show you all of the phases in this video because I want you to explore your own results and apply what you've learned in class about mitosis to recognizing the phases in your own experiment. So go enjoy your very own mitosis scavenger hunt.